You know, This time, it will not tie. Not round my neck.
Round the bedpost, yes. But round my neck, no.
Oh, dear, no. It begs to be excused.
Say it again, Father. Say it again.
A little less noise. Now, I warn you of this, Mother. If this does not go round my neck, we don't go out to dinner tonight. And if we don't go out to dinner tonight, I never go to the office again. And if I don't go to the office again, you and I starve, and our children will be flung into the streets.
I think I have it, Father dear.
Come now, Michael, no more nonsense. Oh, dear Mother, look here, hair all over my trousers. Lovely.
I'll brush you off, Father, dear.
Thank you. You know, Mother, sometimes I think it's a mistake to have a George for a nurse.
Oh, why, George, Nanny is a dreadful.
Yes, no doubt, but at times, I have an uneasy feeling at times that she looks upon the children as her puppies.
Oh, George, we must keep Nana. I'll tell you why. Tonight I saw a face at the window.
A face at the window? Two floors up?
It was the face of a little boy. He was trying to get in.
Impossible.
Oh, it's not the first time I have seen that boy.
Oh.
The first time was a week ago. I remember it was Nana's night out. I had been sitting there by the fire when suddenly I felt a draught as though the window were open. I looked and I saw that boy in the room. I screamed. Oh, just then Nana came back and sprayed him at once. The boy leapt to the window. Nana closed it quickly, but it was too late to catch him.
I thought so.
But wait. He escaped, but his shadow hadn't time to. I hit it. I rolled it up. And here it is.
Aha! Well, I don't think it's anyone we know. He does look a scoundrel, though.
You know, George, I think he comes back trying to find his shadow. But wait, I have told you all. The boy was not quite alone. He was accompanied by a... I don't quite know how to describe it. By a ball of light, no bigger than my fist, but darted around the room like a living thing.
This is most unusual.
What can all this mean, George?
What indeed?
Oh, what have we there, Nana? Oh, the medicine spoon, of course. Thank you, Nana. Michael, time your medicine.
Oh, thank you. Oh, no,
give me. Now, come now, Michael, be a man.
Look,
I'll get you a lovely stick of candy to take after it.
Oh, now, Mother, don't pamper him. Michael.
When I was your age, I used to take my medicine without a murmur. I used to say, thank you, kind parents, for giving me medicine to make me well.
And as an example of you, I would take my medicine now. Only I've lost the bottle.
Oh, I know where it is, Father. I'll bring it.
Wendy!
Oh, it's that horrid stuff. The stick is sweet.
It will soon be over, Father.
Oh, dear.
I've been as quick as I call
them. Yes, you have been wonderfully quick. Precious quick.
Michael, you will see how Father takes.
Michael first.
Father first.
Oh dear, it will make me sick, you know.
I thought you'd be quite mean, Father.
That's not the point. You see, the point is, there's much more in my glass than there is in Michael's food. And it isn't fair.
Come along, Father.
A little less noise there.
Father, I'm waiting.
You're waiting. What about me? I'm waiting.
Father's escaping.
Father is not escaping.
Well,
then you take it.
Let us both take it at the same time.
Certainly. Michael, are you ready? One. Two.
You know, Michael, I don't think you're going to take yours after all.
I am. One, two, three.
Well, that's right. Coddle her. Nobody ever coddles me. I'm only the breadwinner. Why should I be
in my nursery for 1 hour
longer. Oh, no, but I can't even hear you.
In vain, in vain. Your place is in the yard.
No, 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 no.
Do you not remember what I told you about that wolf?
Am I the master in this house, or is she? Come along, Anna. Come on, Anna. Good manner. Nice manner. Kind manner. Pretty manner. Get up there!
Thank you. see, Wendy, when the first baby laughed, for the first time, the laughter broke and went into a thousand pieces and went skipping about. And that was the beginning of fairies. So you see, there ought to be a fairy for every boy.
Ought to be, isn't there?
Oh, no.
Children know such a lot now. And soon when they say, I don't believe in fairies, there's a fairy someplace that falls
down dead.
Never grow old, and that's my home where dreams. one back.
Oh, no, Peeta. I don't mean a kiss. I mean a thing with that. Like this. Ow!
What is it?
Did you catch her?
Mr. Finn, is Peter back dead slightly?
No, twin.
I do wish Peter would come back.
I'm always afraid of the pirate from India. When Peter's not here to protect us.
I wonder what's keeping him so long.
Maybe he's waiting to hear the end of Cinderella.
Well, not knowing anything about my mother, I'm fond of thinking that she's just like Cinderella.
My mother was fonder of me than your mother was of you.
No, she wasn't. Yes, she was.
Peter had to make up names for you. But my mother had wrote my name on the clothes I was lost in. See? Slightly soiled. That's my name.
rising mixed with poison, till it turned a tempting green. We'll place it near our house, just where the boys are sure to come. And being greedy, they won't care to question such a plum. The boys who have no mother sweet, no one to show them their mistakes, well, no, it's dangerous to eat. So dumb and rich a cake. And so the people,
thank you. Down in the hall. The ship, till next year!
Stranger that haunts this dark forest tonight, dost hear me?
Manor and home.
I hear you.
Speak, stranger. Who are you?
I am Hook.
Hook,
captain of the Jolly Roger.
If you're Hook, who am I?
Thank you. Thank you. Don't be afraid, you're not alone. Sleep until the dawn, for all is well. Long ago this song was sung to me. Now it's just a distant melody.
Thank you. Thank you.
something sounds alive. Now is the hour when children in their houses are dead, their lips brightly browned with the goodnight chocolate, their tongues drowsily searching for belated crumbs, housed insecurely on their shining cheeks. Compared with them, the captive children on this boat! Split me into the tears, but 'tis the hour of triumph! Peter killed at last, and all the boys about to walk the plank. At last, I have reached my peak! I am the greatest villain of all time! Who was Bluebeard?
Nobody!
Who was Nero?
Nobody!
Who was Jack the Ripper?
Nobody!
Oh.
Now then,
to walk the plank.
But I have room for two cabin boys. Which of you is it going to be?
I think I heard your volunteer start.
Oh, my mother! Michael, think you did. Now, I
do. It's Hook's frog! So, lad, here's a notion. Open the cabin door and drive them in. Let them fight the doodle-do. If they kill him, we are so much the better. If he kills them, we are none the worse.
Thank you.
Will you treat me as a cipher in my own house?
Excuse me, sir, but what's a cipher?
Well, a cipher is a symbol for a zero, a nothing, a person or thing without power or value.
I don't think he's a cipher. Do you, boy?
Oh, no, sir, and we'll be good children.
All right. Will you treat me with respect?
Yes, sir.
Let me have a little peace and quiet.
People always try to be so fine,
brighter than mice.
Wouldn't that be nice?
We will go like
this. We will grow up and be brighter.
You never have a chance to.
We will never be a bother.
We will never be a bother.
And we'll always shine our shoes.
Oh, to spend them all those shoes.
We have no room.
You see, you're too grown up. Are you ready, Jane?